definition of the primary key is, a primary key is a value that can be used to identify a unique row in a table. Now, what will happen in the database management system? When we want to create any table, we should define a key, and that key is called primary key. So we always use to define the primary key. Now, what is the primary key? So primary key is able to uniquely identify a row. It means that if we'll, let's say if we'll create a roll number as a primary key. So if I want to retrieve the data of roll number one, so always that roll number one, Anil, branch IT, and semester four will come, right? Means it has the capacity to uniquely identify a row in a table. And that is called primary key. Second thing, the same property which we have seen with the super key will be applied here. It means that if we have roll number one available in the table, we cannot enter roll number one again. Means if we have the data of the roll number one, we cannot enter the data of the roll number one again. Otherwise, the line will not going to satisfy. The primary key is the value that can be used to uniquely identify the row. If we have two rows identical, how it can uniquely identify? So we should have only one, not duplicate values, which will come into the database. And that is called primary key. Means that attribute should have the capacity to uniquely identify a row. Can we make roll number as a primary key? So the answer will be no. Can we make name as the primary key? Roll number we can make because every people have different roll number. If we'll talk about persons table, can we make Aadhaar number as a primary key? Yes, we can make. In both the table, person table and the student table, can we make name as the primary key? Is it possible to make name as a primary key? Is name as an attribute can uniquely identify a row? The answer will be no, because even in your class, also, there will be same name of two student. It's possible that two student will have same name. So can we make name as the primary key? No. So what? So we have to identify those attribute which has this property. What property? It can uniquely identify a row. So name doesn't have the property which can uniquely identify a row. If I'll say Abhishek, maybe in your class, there may be two Abhishek. If I'll talk about Sunil, so there may be the chance that in your class, there will be two Sunil, right? So we have to think of any attribute which can uniquely identify a row into the database. So in the database management system keys, primary key always will define while creating the table or while creating the database. And let's talk about candidate key. The meaning of candidate is, let's say we have a election, right? And in one seat, we find many candidates. Means, what is the meaning of candidate? Candidate are nothing but the suitable person who can be the MLA or MP of that particular region, right? So if we'll talk about Bhubaneswar region, there is a, let's say MLA or MP election is going on. So we have multiple entries to become the candidate of that particular region for MLA or MP, right? Here also in the database, maybe we have more than two attribute which can uniquely identify a row. Is it possible? Let's talk about one example. Let's say in the student table, we have roll number. The roll number has property that it can become the primary key. Name, no, it doesn't have the property. Just now we have logically denied it. Let name doesn't have the property to become the primary key. Is branch has the capacity to make a unique row? No, is also not possible, because if I'll say IT branch, so definitely how many student will stand up? I'll say the student IT branch will stand up. So it is not unique, right? Semester is also not unique. Now, if we'll add phone number, so can we say that phone number will become the primary key? So yes, it has the property, because phone number is unique to every student, right? And phone number can become primary key, is possible. So we have two candidate key. What are those? Roll number is one candidate key, phone number is another candidate key. It means that we have two candidate which can become primary key. So candidate is nothing but the set of primary keys, okay, that you can say. So candidate key is nothing but set of primary keys, which can, so any one of the candidate key can become the primary key. Got it? So let's talk about the super key. So super key is nothing but, in a relational model, set of attribute which has these property, which we have just discussed about the primary key. So which has the primary key property, if we'll make the combination of that, that can become the super key. So in the student table, I can make roll number, name as the primary key, sorry, super key, roll number and phone number as the super key. So these two combined can become the super key. Getting it? So this is about these three keys. Let's talk about some more keys which are more interested here. Foreign key, this is another key. So as the name suggests, foreign means it is not the key of a particular table that we are talking about. It is the key of other table.